It's so sunny today, but the temperature keeps dropping. Hey guys, welcome to this week's video. The sun does not make the video so beautiful, but I'm still standing against the sunlight because every hour of sunshine over here is so precious. The winter over here in the north of France is not the same as back home in India. In November, the sun rises at 8 a.m. and sets by 5 p.m. So that does not give you a lot of daytime. When I get out of home, it's dark. And when I get back home in the evening, it's dark. So most of the sunshine is happening when I'm not outside. Today, I'm lucky to be free at this time to soak in all the sun, and that's why I am outside. To give you guys a little bit of perspective, let's talk about the sunshine. Not about the temperature or humidity, just about how many hours of sunshine. Already we have 9 hours of sunshine per day. That brings us to 270 hours in a month, 60 out of which have sunshine. Now, when they say sunlight, they mean that the sun is somewhere behind the clouds over there. And when they say sunshine, that's when the sun is beating down like this. That's why this is so important. It's already going down there, but you probably get half an hour or 45 minutes of sunshine a day. And you're probably doing something important at that time, sitting inside class or you're sitting at work. So that's why I'm standing right in front of the sun when I'm making this week's video. In a couple of weeks, the sunshine will be gone and you'll see how my videos are getting gloomier by the day. I'm not much of a sun guy, but when you don't have any of it, I crave a little bit of sunshine. I checked the weather this morning and it said that it's going to be sunny all day. I didn't believe it because last week we had 5 gloomy days out of 6 and today was sunny. Now that we are here in the sun, enjoying the sunlight, although it's just 6 degrees, let's get to what we're talking about today. I visited a friend of mine and we were working on an assignment together and he didn't know his Wi-Fi password. So he asked his roommates, they didn't know it either. I googled it with my 4G because his computer was connected to the Wi-Fi and I thought that I could retrieve it. I could with Windows 8, but now with Windows 10 on his laptop, I was not able to do the same. I tried it on his Android phone, which was also connected to the Wi-Fi, but I could not do it. Eventually, his roommate came over who had a Mac, thankfully. And on a Mac, there's an easy way to find out all the passwords that you've saved. Let's dive in. To start off, open this app called Keychain Access. Just hit Command and Space together and type in the Spotlight Keychain and open this app. Make sure you're on the Passwords tab here on the left and look for the Wi-Fi whose password you want to find. Of course, you should have saved this on your computer before, only then it's gonna show up. Once you found it, double click it and hit Show Password. Now it'll ask you to sign into your computer just to make sure everyone cannot have access to this. Enter the password of your computer and there's your password. It's as simple as that. If you don't know what your password is, you don't have to go behind the router every time. If you can pull it out from here, do it. Or just save this on Chrome. To know how to do that, you just check out the video I did last week because I was talking about that last week. You can save this Wi-Fi password on your Chrome. That way, when you pull out your phone, you can still open it on your Chrome and then give it to your friends. Or just simplify the password. That's about another video. It's as simple as that, folks. It's as simple as that to find out the passwords saved on your Mac computer. I tried my best with Windows 10, but I could not find a way out. If you do find a way out, please let me know how you did it. I read a couple of blog articles and then just gave up. Pro tip, if you hit this key logo back in Keychain Access, it suggests passwords to you. Choose memorable, that way the passwords are memorable, and it suggests passwords. Just move the slider to make them longer, and it gives you really creative passwords. Some of my passwords are combinations of these things. Because what is your password? Don't tell me, but what is your password? Maybe it's just something very predictable, like your birthday or your name or 1234 or admin 123. Make sure that it's not guessable. If you look at how creative these passwords are, I don't think anyone can guess them. Just move them around, add your favorite numbers, add characters, and you're safe. Do you hear that car sound? I thought it'll stop, but it's not stopping. I'll just finish my video anyway. That's it for this video, guys. Hope that was helpful. Take care of yourself, and I'll see you next week. Until then, keep learning.